time for a two-pack. Babies, it's Reactivate, the new Transformers game coming out soon. Soundwave Optimus Prime 2-pack, I got it here for you. We're going to look at one of the figures, one of the two, and then in a follow-up review, almost like an old-school YouTube two-parter, we'll visit the other one. Today, we're looking at Optimus Prime. In rolls Optimus Prime, looking absolutely brutal. Look at this dude, man. He's not playing games anymore. Like, he is looking rough. Holy goodness, man. This is a mean-looking Optimus Prime. That's your friendly neighborhood Optimus Prime. This dude's got a spiked cow catcher all beat up and scratched up in the front of it. The rest of him's pristine, but he's a nice, hefty figure. He looks mean and rough, man. I like this deco a lot. This is not your typical Optimus Prime here. You know, he's not coming in with the 80s truck version. Now he's coming in to ram something. Like any good toy nowadays, you can store his weapons in this mode. And this is his Wavemate Soundwave. Also looking really cool and very Mad Maxy. I'm really digging this Reactivate stuff, man. Oh, I might have to get my hands on some more of it. And look at this, as a little bonus, you can even access the removable Matrix of Leadership in this mode, which I won't remove. People, it's time to do the thing. Guy, he's all beefy and bulky and burly and mean looking. Looks like he's been hitting the gym, man. He's on the synth end, if you know what I'm saying. Like, he's just all, he's like powerful looking, man. He's nice and the toy is hefty too. It's a nice thick heavy plastic. The tolerances are really, really tight on everything. I got like indentions in my fingers here trying to manipulate this thing. He's super tight. I got to get him loosened up if I want to actually like mess with him, because he's fun to mess with. The transformation is cool and unique, and he cleans up pretty well. If you plug things in properly, he even cleans up better. See, that's what he looks like from behind. But yeah, man, so I put his axe here. He's got the Energon axe, which is like an ashy yellow, which it looks pretty cool. And then he's got his big ion cannon blaster thing. So yeah, man, I'm liking it. I like his face sculpt too. I think this is a total win. All right, we'll make it quick, but people like to see this. So I'm going to do it anyway. You can see what's going on here. Does 360s. He's got this and that. Those will go 360, but they're really, really tight. Arrgh, I can barely do it. Waist goes 360. That's nice. He's got the Perceptor kick. He's got the kick you right in the mouth, maybe even kick himself in the mouth. He's got a bend at the leg, which is over 90. That's real cool. And then he does have ankle rocker, but again, they're pretty tight as well. No ankle pivot. Like, he doesn't have a front to back, just a rocker. So that's a little bit awkward, but it's fine. Overall, this guy is pretty excellent, man. This is going to be a strong recommend from this guy. The only thing I don't like about him is the Games Workshop gray in some areas. And I kind of wish his fists were blue, but that's just me being dorky. Let's put him with other primes, shall we? And here he is with this guy. A little bit of that. Some of you. Some Happy Father's Day. And yes, he will fit in the back of Cybertronian Wheeljack. It's been a long road, people, and this has been Mitch Santona. You have been a phenomenal audience for years and years. I truly appreciate all of you. Got a lot of nice comments lately. And I'm just real grateful for you, man. Thank you so much for continuing to tune into this in all seriousness. I'll keep doing it if you guys keep watching. So take care, everybody. Thank you for watching. And you know how we do this outro. Arrivederci, babies.